Hey guys, welcome back to Rage Quit Gaming. Today's is a clan drill. It's a particularly good one we did in Arnhem called Battle Buddies. Basically, we are training teamwork and cooperation. We tried it in squads, and it seems harder than you think. So I sort of break it down today into two-man squads. You've got to cover your mates back, look after them, always stick together like shit on a shovel, or whatever this phrase is going along with. So yeah, it's an arm lane. The premise is that there's two teams, two infantry squads and one logistics. So you capture the first point, build a fob, everyone waits at their own fob until they're live, and then you go capture the next points. And then that was like a fair start for everyone, and they all rushed in pretty good, so they all got their first two points captured. As you'll see, it's great. Look at these shots of the planes, they're amazing, eh? Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm sorry about the commentary not being live. Apparently my mic betrayed me. Judas Iscariot mic. That's a really bad pun. Anyway, enjoy, here we go. So as you can see,
well, I put a vehicle tent though, it may give away the game that we have a fob here. So if you feel that's true, take it down.
Alpha put their fob there. They've already captured the first point. Their second point is up just north of that church you can see there. The other side of that church, and so they put their fob quite a long way away, a lot further than Bravo's is, as you can see from their point. You see just right at the church there's a bigger building with some like gothic arches along the roof line. That's the Bravo's capture point, second capture point. And if you'll see, if you just see on the right there, that's where Bravo's fob is, on the right where the red mark is. I think this is good positioning from Bravo's. We're live now, so off we go. We've got the two buddy teams now over here. One is running with the squad vehicle, and the other is taking the half-track infantry carrier towards Bravo's second point, so it looks like they're going to try and interrupt the cap, while the other fire team, led by Ham, is going to go and take their point. But it looks like all of Bravo have just gone to take their point here, which is probably a sensible decision, considering. So there come Wagon Neves up the avenue there in the Bren carrier, which is actually a decent piece of armour.
Are you planning on a...
weakness I was talking about. That was a great push from them there. Unfortunately for them, Acid has a good arm. He goes away from home a lot, you know, so he's probably built up the strength in that arm. So yeah, we've got Ham, Aaron, and first.
Nice hammer, buddy.
Their point. Looks like they've done that now. And Bravo should have captured there, so this is when the battle will kick off properly. There's only one cameraman out there today, guys, so there's only one angle, so we will miss some of the action, but I think the briefing is to try and focus on... See, Bravo are pushing into attack there, those little red guys. I think Ham is aware of them coming. Yeah, look, he's poking his head out. And there's the first engagement. So who have we got here? Let's have a look. I'm just going to use my magic commentator powers to make this bigger so I can actually read names. So we've got first, I think, engaging with...
Fuck, grenade.
Oh, it was Aaron.
He's
fucked by a grenade. So, communication between the two buddies. Let him know he's down. We got Kane pushing up on his buddy. On Aaron here. First, holding the building he's in because he knows he's got guys on the other side and he can't do anything yet. We got Neves and Mark who are reflanking round towards their point. That was Pickle there, the logistics player for Bravo, the red team. They're just going past the pub, they don't realise it yet. Almost was going to use the colleague on the other side though. So it looks like when we were away we missed Ham and first kill that push from Bravo. So they killed the three guys there. Ham, you know, not raining his ego there and just claiming just unnecessary saying I'm a gamer. Oh, let's see. Oh, here's Guild Team Kuma working together as a team. They've come round as well. They've sank on the other team was getting murdered. They don't know they're there, and Bravo have pushed their other set of their other buddy fire team up to support Neves and Wag. Neves and Wag, who are now entering the town hall, which is being defended by Acid, who's actually playing as a solo Yeater today rather than a fire team. It looks like First and Aaron are going to run into looks like that's Rogers and Kane.
Let's get a good angle on them.
Aye.
Nice. I'm on the top of the world.
Same.
Oh.
So we've got Aaron and First. They've pulled back because Ham spotted them. So they've killed... It looks like they've killed Guilty here and Kuma's left alive. Ham's pushed around behind. Oh, I think that was a team kill. They get Kuma there.
I've got him.
Very nice. They're going to rest hand.
Get me up quick and then move
the panel. We'll try and ignore that team kill because it never happened. And Wog and Neebs have found themselves up onto the roof of the building next to the town hall. It's quite a commanding spot.
Over there, do you see Far Church?
So what's the people? Oh, it looks like Neve went down there. Looks like that was a team kill as well. Looks like Wog team killed Neve.
Sorry Neve, got you. You're a bad spot.
Turning on the see the domes there. I've just turned on the cap so you can see where they are. What I have done is turn off the names, which actually at the time was really frustrating because it's like three buttons and you don't really know what they do. You just have to smash them until you get the right display you want. I'm going to go with this is Aaron or First pushing down here. Might even be that. Who actually knows? But he's pushing right up on Bravo's spawn radio here, and four of Bravo. He goes into here. And he gets deservedly murdered. Log's still alive, taking pot shots at. I think if I remember that's. But the rest of Bravo now, they're throwing over their kill. And it looks like they're going for a flank. Oh no, I was wrong, they're just hiding in a corner. Putting down a new radio, okay. So we've still got... It looks like Neve is back to Wog's position. So, Wargan Neebs is now holding this point, but then two of Faro pushing to clear out the cap point. I don't quite know. Wog might have got one of those kills. I mean, it's difficult to say with the stairs on top of the roof, you know? Wog still holding Bravo's first cap point. It looks like they're being... Alan's coming in here for support. Oh no, that's he got shot earlier. He looks like he hasn't released. He may be waiting for first to come and res him. Who's there now? You can see. Well, up, now they're on the move again. Looks like Neebs destroyed Bravo's vehicle there. Which has triggered Kane, I think this is, down here. He's going to try and hunt him. Neebs moves just in time there. Neebs gets out. Last minute, and Rogers knows. We've got first, who's been killed here now. I wonder if Aaron made it. We've got... Ham defending with bow, I imagine. We've got Warg still on the roof. In fact, Neebs is pushing back. Oh, we've got, I think that's Pickle pushing up on the, that's Pickle. He's the logistics player for Bravo, who's pushing up on the cap point. I'm just a bit, so I realised that... It was set for 1 hour 40 minutes, and we didn't really want to play that long with two scores of six, so... So it's Logic just joined the match.
Any news, bro? They kind of spread out around Town Hall.
So Logic is playing the Acid role, which I'm going to refer to as the Yeeter. We've got Guilty and Kuma coming across the road here. They're going to set up in that house. We have got first and Aaron coming back in on the south side here. Fast burning burning carrier. And it looks like Ham and Logic are pushing back. Coming from the other side. So it's a pincer attack here by Alpha. Oh, they killed one guy there. They blew up Bravo's radio. Now they're going to cross the street. Rifle grenade. As you can see, that rifle grenade got Ham. Rogers and Winter there, holding the town hall. Got Wild above them. There you go, that's Ham getting more. I knew you got Ham with a rifle grenade at some point. No, it was. That was a great shot for whoever did that. Val for holding this. I will come back with some commentary when it gets more exciting in a bit.
But if you push into Town Hall, we cap it with them. Myself and Logics will go back to Cooper Cove.
Thank you.
What? He's walking past me. There's two guys on his evil.
One's dead.
Thank you.
add a minute or two to that game time, so it doesn't end suddenly. Unless you want to end it, actually. Yeah, he just rejoined. So Gnades is going to AFK.
So we're coming towards the end of the match now, guys. As you can see, it's pretty much the same as when I left the commentary 20 minutes ago. Alpha is still pushing on Bravo's first points, and Bravo having to defend because they can't get the initiative. One of Bravo's trucks exploded for no reason.
Bo, do you know what that explosion is?
Han doesn't know either. So yeah, there's no one out on the point, but they're both moving in.
Explosion, I'm sorry, Ham.
Don't worry, there was an explosion towards Han Hall, but I think my guys dealt with it.
I think Pickle is on that infantry marker, he was on the top floor.
There's
that building trying to snipe me.
We've got two pushing in here. They are on all around acid. In fact, there's still Kane. Oh no, Kane's still up. South is running there right by Kane. Kane should know he's there. Kane hasn't moved, but I don't blame him with an MG going off above his head. Oh, it looks like Lodge has killed. Logic is coming around to kill Rogers. Let's see who went to the battle. If he was across from the window there, he would have killed him. Looks like he's going to take the line down. So let's go check out the action at this end.
I'm just trying to shoot
myself. I'm just going to pause it while I can try and work motion sick from commentating on the contact.
Got a shot at him, Justin.
Repeat, bud.
He's in my location, Pickle.
Please repeat, bud. Sorry.
Not sure if we traded or not.
Where was he? I can't find your bodies.
Yeah, even the lower floor. By me.
I found your people.
Okay. Alright.
So he messaged me saying he whiffed some shots, so I think he may have killed him.
Towards the end of the match, guys. Just over 5 minutes left. As you can see, Bravo is still being held back by Alpha for the early initiative. They semi destroyed the fob that Bravo had, and they have built a new one, but it's too far towards the train station, and so it's not close enough to be effective to get back and defend this point, so it kind of main speed towards down. My wind is down. I'm just left alive in a bush there. Random skirmishes coming towards the end now. Again. About 3 minutes left. They've got no one on the point, but they have the points. So we've got Gilton and Kuman this end.
Well, any news at Kapuka?
You want me down by you? I was kind of defending this point, but I come your way.
Yeah. Is there anything there? I guess not then.
Nothing at the moment.
Okay. Yeah, we've only got a couple of minutes where it's a bit of a question with us in town. They have a half track on the east side though.
Moving in here. Just Mrs. Aaron. He knows where he is though, and he goes on the other side of the wall, so if you can see him, but Aaron's in a bush. You've seen Aaron's bush play earlier. I wasn't commentating in that section, but that was a pretty good part of hiding in a bush. Oh, it looks like Kane then knew where he was, threw a grenade on. It's a shame. Oh, we almost missed with the commentating work and Neebs. Earlier on, they engaged Pickle and destroyed his truck, which I imagine made Pickle a bit cross, and that's why he went and tried to stab Ham, which is a good response, as far as I can tell. One should always try and stab Ham. So we've got Alpha pushing into the point again there. We've got Bravo set up to defend. Right, they've stopped trying to attack and they're just defending this point. As you saw earlier, Alpha really very nearly capped it, and that's what's given the ticket lead. I mean, it's only a small ticket lead, but that's what they need now, with only a minute or so to go. Killing you to move out and then moving into the courtyard to be in the capsule. Alpha and Wedding behind the floor and they're getting grenaded by.
Two at my tag, Ham. Two EI at my ham, at my tag.
Perfect. Thank you, man.
Two enemy infantry at both divisions. There's got people sneaking along through a bush. Alpha in course by the town hall. Someone's not grenades across there. I think that's Pickle throwing grenades. Alpha countering with some smoke to cover them. Oh, that could have been rifle grenades fired by Guilty from this position here. Quite possible. He's a great shot with the rifle grenade. Looks like we've got a Ham going up onto the roof again. So he can be closer to God. He's got Overwatch. We've got 16 seconds left now. It looks like this is definitely going to be a win for Alpha. Only on ticket, so it's a technical victory. They didn't win outright. Let's see how the kill count went.